Morning to all of you. This morning we have with us an eminent educationist to share his experiences and to orient us as to how to study in a smart way. He is none other than Mr. Paul Machado. He had been a principal of Campion School for more than 17 years. I'm sure you'll be happy to know that prior to going to Campion School, St. Mary's was fortunate to have him as the vice principal of St. Mary's School. Many of the teachers who have taught you were his own colleague. Let me share something about him. He is a member of management committee of the Association of Heads of Anglo-Indian School. Last year, he was the president of this very association. He's an inspector, an assessor of CISCE schools. He's also joint secretary of UMIND, that is European Union Meets India. He has received several awards. Just to mention few of them, he was conferred CISCE, that is Council of Secondary Certificate Education, prestigious, one of the most prestigious award known as Dergio Award for Education and Human Enrichment in 2017. And he was ranked number one. He was awarded for Best Boys Day School in India for Leadership and Management. I'm sure all of you have been reading about him. The very schools, Campion School, where he was at the helm of affairs, was awarded 7 years consecutively as a Best Boys Day School. There are many awards which he has received. A list is long. Just to avoid, due to the time constraint, let me end on saying right now, he's the Director of Education of the Campion Board. Paul, Mr. Paul Machado, the St. Mary's School welcomes you back again to address us and to share your enriching experience at Campion. I'm sure my students of St. Mary's will surely a profit and enriched by your experience as to how to study smartly. Over to you, Paul.
Thank you, Father. I would have been very happy to come to St. Mary's physically. I would have felt at home after spending 14 and a half years at Mary's. You know, after 14 years, I can say after 17 years, I feel really, you know, excited to address the Marians. Now, to tell you frankly, my foundation years or whatever I have learned as an administrator or as a teacher, I think I must give credit to St. Mary's. St. Mary's has been my foundation institution. So thanks you, Father, for introducing me. And I had some network issues. I hope I'm audible now. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, yes, sir. Okay, the boys. Okay, anyhow, in my 40 years of teaching experience, for the last 32 years, I've been teaching only in boys' school. So therefore, it becomes very easy for me to connect with the boys. So time and again, you may hear me saying boys instead of saying students. Okay? Okay. So the boys, let's make this as very interactive. So I would like you all to take part in this. Here more, I will be just guiding you all. It's more of you are the ones who are talking to yourself and to your friends. So let's begin with, as and when you want to raise some issues or questions, or you want to share something, something that you know that you can always raise a hand, and then your webmaster over there will monitor and coordinate the entire thing. Okay, let's begin with, can we have the slide starting over there? Let's see. Okay, so this is not necessary to discuss. Okay, is understood. Father has already introduced me. Okay, so now today is basically the theme is study smart, not hard. So let's see, anybody would like to say, what do you understand by this? Study smart and not hard. Anyone would like to communicate? Anyone? So what do you mean by this? Study smart, not hard. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. So may I? So,
yeah.
Yes, sir.
So study smart, not hard actually means don't put in too much of hard work for mm-hmm. only studying, but also be smart and try to study most of it in short amounts of time.
Okay, very good. But you know, so when you say
that.
Hello? Hello? Can you hear me? Hello?
Yes.
Okay. So when you say don't study hard, okay, so you don't have to study hard. I don't think some of your parents will agree to it. Am I right? So, but what you said is absolutely right. You know, what you study is not just the quantity, but it's the quality. How much time you spend is not important. How you study, that is very, very important. So in case if I'm not audible, please let me know, because I have a network issues over here today. Okay, can I go to the next slide?
So may I say something?
Yes, please. Who is this? Can you introduce yourself? Say your name at least.
So my name is Ridham Jogani. I'm from class 3 and I've taken ECO as my subject, main subject. Okay. So what my friend did say that you're supposed to not study, like you're not supposed to do hard work. What I feel is, sir, even if you're studying smart, you need hard work. Like studying hard and doing hard work is two different things. Like he said that you're not supposed to do hard work, but I totally disagree with it. Even if I'm studying smart and supposed to do hard work, I'm supposed to give my 100%. So that's what I feel. Okay. I do not agree with it. Even if I'm studying, I need to give my hard work.
Okay, I agree with you. So let us in this session, let us agree to disagree with one another. Yeah, because all of us have our own thoughts, own views. So, but I agree with you as well as I agree with your classmate, whoever is said it. Okay, let's as we go through this session. Okay, let's see whether it is what exactly is the hard and what exactly is the smart. Okay, okay. Anybody would like to say something about this picture? Just what you see on your screen?
Yes, I want to say.
Yeah, please, Amit. Yeah, please.
Sir, do we manage our time accordingly?
Do we manage our time accordingly? I'm talking about this picture that you have on your screen. Can you see all that?
Sir, can I say it?
Yeah, there's a boy, just like a St. Mary's boy. Yeah?
Upar dekh rahe.
Please. So what do you think about this boy?
Sir, he is wasting.
Say that he is one of the St. Marian. So let's see, what is he?
Sir, he is wasting his time.
So he is wasting his time by doing both of them at the same time.
Okay, he's wasting his time.
Social media and studies.
Okay. What else?
So it could also be an online class, sir. So it could also be an online class, a teacher taking an online class.
Okay,
it can be also an online class. Sir, I am frustrated studying too much.
Uh-huh. Anybody else? Anyone anymore? See, different opinions are coming up. Anyone else?
I don't think it can be an online class because a student won't sit like this with his camera on in an online class.
Yeah, online class, the student will switch off the camera and go to sleep. Am I right?
He'll go to sleep somewhat. Yes,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Father Swami is there to record all this, huh?
No, okay. Not exactly. We're just talking about it.
Okay. We're just talking about it. I agree with you. Okay. Anybody else? Anything else?
So probably he's looking up because he's stressed. He's like so much of studies.
Very good.
Sir, and probably, sir, thinking he's studying, but he's actually watching some movie.
No. Sir, he's cockeyed.
He's not studying smart.
So if you look at the left hand side back, it is written study hard. So probably his motive is, you know, to study hard and not study smart. like only study, like he's only watching it time wise, like I studied for 6 hours, 7 hours, he's not watching how much did he study. So probably because of that he's stressed.
Yeah.
Because if you see study harder, so it's on the left hand side. So that's what this motto might be.
I must give you credit for the observation, you know, that study hard, that corner it is put. Also, yeah, okay, all of you that you have mentioned, you know, given your opinion, so everyone is right. There is no wrong answer, or there's no right answers. Each one is opinion, that is. If you look at him, as you said, he may be stressed. Something he may be also thinking what to do. He doesn't know what to do. He doesn't have a plan on sight. Am I right? When you don't have a plan, this is what you all do. Okay, it's like that. So there are different opinions from different people. Yeah, okay, good. Thank you so much. Let's go to the next. Okay, so now already we understood what is a study smart, not hard. You know, already you said it. Okay, so therefore you don't have to spend a lot of time in studying the same thing over and again, over and again. I'm sure the teachers will be telling you in the classroom, go through your textbook once, see what you understood, mark, underline it, and okay, make a note of your own. Later in the second time when you are studying the same subject, same chapter, don't go through the textbook again and again, but go through the notes that you have gone. That means you are saving a lot of time. That is what it means, a smart study. You're not hard, studying hard. The people who study hard, what we call it as, they keep on repeating or reading the same thing from the textbook time and again, till the examination. And then on the examination day, sometimes they may, you know, go blank. This is the chances. It's not necessary, but this is a few chances. Okay. Let's see, in order to study smart and not hard, what are the first thing? First thing is to decide that studying is important. Do you agree with this, with me? Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me why studying is important. Tell me. Now you're in the 10th standard, your mommy, daddy, your teachers, the principal would be saying, you need to study. Now, have you ever asked yourself, why should I study? Why is it important?
So studies help us in the future by, like when you go for jobs also, they first see your 10th result, then your 12th result, then your CV and all that.
Okay. At this moment, the studying is important in order to get high marks. So therefore you become a successful person later. Am I right? So yeah, let us see. Sir. What do you mean by success? Is the success same to everyone?
Some people might have different goals, so success might be different for different people.
Okay, success is different to different. It is very relative, am I right? For me, what success means
exactly
is different than what success means to you. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
sir. So for some of you, the success may be to become a millionaire. For some of you, it may be success means you want to become a social worker. For some of you, success means to lead a happy life, okay, family life. So therefore, it varies from person to person. But however, you right now at this moment as a student, you need to study in order to be successful later in life. Okay, that's the first step. So understand studying is important. Second is you need to motivate yourself in order to achieve that goal. At this moment, boys, you know, as a preliminary examinations around the corner, then ICSE board examinations will be somewhere in April, May. So you need to also set your goals. Am I right? So you need to have right now at this goal, what is the goal that you are setting yourself in order to be successful in the examination, forthcoming examination. So once you set that goal, you need to motivate yourself in order to achieve those goals. So you need to learn, you need to put down certain process there. Okay. So let us see one by one now. There are four fundamentals of effective studying. Okay, the next slide. Okay, first important is belief in yourself. I will deal with one by one and then I'll go afterwards. Okay, then preparation, where to study, when to sleep to motivate yourself. And the last one is a discipline. It's an important aspect of our life. Okay, so let's take one by one. What exactly believe in yourself mean? Okay, now, the next slide. See, believe in yourself. Let me tell you, the biggest difference I have noticed as an educationist between the successful people and the unsuccessful people is not intelligence or opportunity or resources. It is the belief that they can make their goals happen. So you need to believe in your capabilities. Once you believe in your capabilities, I'm sure you will succeed. Now, today, if you say, I'm going to get 90%, that's the belief and that's the goal that you are setting. But you also need to believe in your capabilities. Okay, I am capable of achieving that 90% at my, and then you set the process in place. Honestly, if you don't believe, boys, please keep in your mind, if you don't believe you are going to succeed, then how on earth would anybody else believe you? You as an individual, if you don't believe yourself and your capabilities, you don't expect someone else to believe your capabilities. You know very well what are your capabilities. Yeah. Then if you're not confident enough, you will break like a twig the first time you face an obstacle. That's what happens for us students. You know, when you're not confident of your capabilities, when you fail, you don't get up. You don't get up. Okay. And whatever you want to achieve, there will be countless barriers questioning your competences. So let me ask you one thing. You know, in school also as students, you know, over the different examinations, you may be getting maybe say 50 marks, 60 marks. Suddenly you will get somewhere about 75, 80 marks. What will be the reaction of your friends and the teachers? Anybody would like to share?
So that we have cheated.
Okay.
That's no, pardon, sir. I didn't get the question.
I said if you're getting about 50%, 60% in the examination, suddenly in one of the examinations, you get 75 to 80%. So what would be the reaction of the teachers and your peers?
It depends upon the mindset of the teachers and the peers. They might think we've cheated or they might think we have studied hard for the exam and got those marks with our own efforts.
Okay, but what I'm trying to communicate right now here is that you will have barriers. If somebody says, okay, how did you get? The first reaction would be from your peers is, you used to get only 50%. How did you manage to get 80%? But if you don't have the confidence in your capabilities and if you go by what that boy or a peer is saying, you are going to be, you know, completely demotivated. So therefore, you need to believe in yourself. Say, okay, I worked hard and I got that 80%. And you should be confident to say that. You say, I have got 80% because I worked hard and this is what I did. That's what I've been trying. I'm trying to communicate to you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. The next point you can see, you inspire yourself to take action. So once you believe in yourself, you inspire yourself. You know, have you watched Michael Jordan's documentary in the Netflix? You all are watching Netflix, yes. Am I right?
Yes.
Yeah. Most of you must be watching Netflix, Prime Video, you know, Disney Hotstar, whatever it is. In the Netflix, I was watching this documentary of Michael Jordan. You know who is Michael Jordan?
Yeah. Yes,
all the sports people will remember, you know, basketballers will remember. Famous basketball player. Yeah? Okay. So let me, so those who have watched this documentary can say something about it? Can anybody? Hello?
We haven't seen.
Hello? You're not seen. Okay, anyway, let me tell you, Michael Jordan did not become famous overnight. Did he become famous overnight? No. He failed countless times. If you see that documentary also, you'll come to know. If you're not watched, I think somewhere down, you know, during your break times, you can watch. He failed countless times. As he admits, he missed thousands of shots and lost hundreds of games. But he realized that it is a part of process, okay? So he used it as a driving force to work even harder. He also emphasizes its failure that enabled him for a huge success, okay? So therefore, let me tell you here, failing is not a mistake, please keep in your mind, but not learning from your failure is a great sin, okay? All of us as human beings, we tend to fall. But if you remain where you are fallen, then you are a failure in life. But if you can rise up with all the motivation and inspire yourself to rise again, and you'll be a success. So please keep that in your mind. The third point he says, you form positive attitude required to success. As I said, you need to believe in yourself. You need to have the positive attitude that I can do it. You know, by being negative and visioning the worst scenario is the easiest way to never to achieve your goals. You know, and as a student in school, oh, I can't study this. Math is very, very difficult. I can't study. I can't mug up history. Because already you are sending a signal to your mind saying that it is not possible for me. So why don't we say, oh, math is very easy. It's like just a chess game. I can play it. Okay. History is a very simple. I can just read it like a story. So, you know, pass on these statements to your mind. So automatically you will change your outlook, change your attitude towards these subjects, which you find it is difficult. But if you have that negative and already worse scenario in your mind, then you will do it. You will succeed accordingly. So whatever the way you want to succeed, this is what happens. Now, for example, cricketers. So let me, because most of you must be watching cricket, playing cricket, you can enjoy cricket. So if a batsman goes onto the field, oh, I'm going to be out for the first ball. So is he going to score a century? No. He has to walk onto the field with the bat in his hand saying that, okay, today I'm going to score a century. Okay, this is how I'm going to play. So even if he doesn't, but he has gone with the positive mind. But when he comes back, he will sit down and watch himself in his, on his, can say, video and see where has he gone wrong. And he will correct it. And it's next time he'll go. But if he had gone with a negative mind, when he comes back, he's going to sit himself. He's not going to watch, not going to improve. So that is what it is. You have to have that positive attitude required for a success. Now, the next statement that you can see on your screen, be in a positive state of mind. Always keep in mind, you have to say this statement morning, afternoon, night. I can do it. Use this magic mantra. I can, I will, and I must. And picture yourself being successful. So, you know, when you say I can and I will and I must, so then what happens is that you're picturing yourself very successful. So just, okay. So next slide will show you that exactly what does it mean. Next slide. Okay. So you can see the slide. See, no, previous slide, please. Okay. So you can see that I won't do it. The first step is, okay. Slowly you can change it. I can't do it. You get into that stage where I cannot do it, say. But then you say, I want to do it. Okay. And there you have changed your mindset. Now they went to succeed. You'll say, how did I do it? Okay. Then next step, you said, okay, since I succeeded, no, let me try next one. Then I can do it and I will do it. And at the end you say, I did it. And you feel happy. You know, this is what it is. When you set a goal for yourself, later I'll tell you what is exactly a SMART goal is all about. When you set a goal yourself, say, I'm going to get a 95 in my preliminary examination. And when you get it, you actually become very, you know, very happy and rejoice. But I also need to sit back and see the process that you put in order to achieve that. So therefore, you need to can move ahead. So if there is any, you know, shortcoming in the process, you can rectify it and move ahead. Yeah. Okay. So let's go to the next one. Okay. Now that you have to do preparation is where to study. Am I right? So come on, anybody tell me, where do you all study at home? So most of you are blessed to have your room for yourself. There are people in the world or in the country, in Mumbai city, where they have only one room. Okay, tell me, where do you have a place at home to sit? Is it ideally meant for studying or for other entertainment?
There is a desk next to my bed. That's where I study.
Okay, next to your bed. So therefore, you sleep on the bed?
No, I sit on the bed.
Oh, you sit on the bed.
Keep my pillows as a backrest.
Okay, backrest. Okay. And most of the time you're sitting down and studying, or most of the time I'm lying and studying?
Sitting down.
Hmm?
I'm sitting down most of the time.
Most of the time. Okay. So ideally, if I have to ask you, you need to have a place is only meant for studying. Okay. If it is not possible, yes, you have to makeshift whatever the rooms that are available in the house, you have to do makeshift or work. Okay. Not your bed. Bed is not supposed to be a study place, because bed is, there is a specific purpose for each furniture in the house. Am I right? So that means the moment you are in a bed, you will be forced or tend to just lie on the bed as and when you are tired mentally and physically. Not in the living room. Why not in the living room? If you have a living room, there's the most disturbance there. Am I right? There's a lot of disturbance. Yes. Yeah, mommy, daddy, your brother, sisters will be watching TV or walking up and down. You cannot concentrate. Like in Mumbai city, as the people go on to the college, you'll say, oh, let's go to the coffee shop and study. Even the coffee shop is not a studying place. Am I right? Because there's a lot of disturbance. Any amount, you say, oh, I can study better. But it is all the myth. Best place is a desk in your, okay, as you said, you can put a desk rather than sitting on the bed, put a desk and a chair and a bedroom, anywhere that you find relatively free of distractions. You also need to have adequate light and a fresh air is important. Close to the window, that will be best, okay?
So you can study. Okay, when you're tired, you can just stand up and look out, enjoy the nature. That also is important for your eyes. Okay.
When to study, as I said, you need to have either an early morning or a late morning. How many of you feel you can study early morning well?
So every day I wake up at 4 and study till 7.
Okay, very good. And at what time do you go to sleep?
So 9:30.
Okay, so you have a 7 hour sleep, am I right? More than 7 hours.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So what about anybody else want to share your study habits?
So I study late at night, sir. I can't study.
So anybody? I start studying in the afternoon, but I make sure I finish at least one chapter's revision by evening.
Okay. Anyone else would like to share?
I study at night from around 12 to 1 or maybe 2 just to finish off whatever decided and then go off to sleep.
Okay. Okay. So you can see here itself with the three students who shared there, there are certain students can study in the morning well, some of them can study late in the evening. Okay, so therefore, according to your body, you know, what you call constitution, you need to study. It doesn't mean that your friend studies very well in the morning, gets up at 4 o'clock, studies till 7 o'clock. You know, your mommy may say, see your friend gets up at 4 o'clock. You also should get up at 4 o'clock, but your body mechanism may not be suitable to that. So if you feel that, okay, I can study late in the night, maybe I can study from 9 to 12 o'clock, 9 to 1 o'clock. Okay, I study well that time. So yes, you make your study timetable there. But however, please keep in your mind that you have, that is 7 hours of sleep without fail, minimum 6 to 7 hours sleep is mandatory. So you divide yourself because it depends from one person to the other person, you know, it is not the same to everyone. So therefore you don't go by that. Okay. So this is what also means a smart studying, you know, understand the time is very suitable for you to study and remember. Okay. Rather than just taking a book and studying, okay, my mommy has told me, daddy has told me, my friends are studying, so let me get up at 6 o'clock or 4 o'clock, let me go. Nothing is happening. You're studying hard because nothing is getting into your mind, okay, because that is not your body, okay? Body mechanism says you study late in the night when there is no distractions, so you sit. So therefore, you decide what is the right time for you to study, yeah? Okay, the next slide will say about something about your learning styles, if I'm not mistaken, yes? Okay, I think father must have sent you one questionnaire. Am I right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Did you all answer that?
Yeah.
Yes. Sir.
Okay. Now let me know. I want at least one person who says I am a visual learner, I am an auditory learner, and I am kinesthetic learner. So I want you to say something about why did you consider yourself as a visual learner after answering those sections. Okay. Anybody?
So.
See, let me tell you, one minute. Let me tell you, all of us have these all three styles. Of course, there are many more styles than three. Right now, I'm talking about visual, auditory, and kinesthetic learners. Now, it doesn't mean that we are only visual learners or only auditory learners, only kinesthetic learners. But all these three aspects are in us, but one will be predominant. So anybody would like to share something about visual learner?
Excuse me, sir, if you don't mind me asking. So what does kinesthetic mean?
Kinesthetic, okay. Most of, as far as I know, in a boys' school, no? How many of you sit quiet in the classroom when the teacher is teaching? Very few, no? How many of you enjoy doing things and work, okay, so studying? You know, so kinesthetic means more, you know, your body, you know, you want to do something, activity-based learning. That is what it is, kinesthetic is. I'll explain to you that one by one. But let me ask you, visual learners. Who are the visual learners? Anyone would like to share?
Visual learners who only relies on seeing and learning.
Okay. Are you the visual learner, Fashwa?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So you enjoy. How do you learn? Tell me. You tell me about yourself. How do you learn?
So first I read the chapter very well. Okay. So then the side, I mark all the important parts of the chapter and highlight them so that I can skip the parts that are not important.
Okay.
And then the second time again, I read very well. So this time I make notes and all.
Okay.
So then I only study from my notes.
From your notes, the underlined, highlighted, am I right?
Yes.
So when you're underlining, highlighting, that actually impacts you. I mean, it makes your study easy. Okay, so those are the visual learners. Now, for example, right now here, I'm talking, am I right? Also, the slides have been put on the screen. So the visual learners will look at it and try to see what it is.
Okay. And the next ones are the auditory learners. Anybody auditory learners? I'll come back to the visual learners. I'll come back to the visual learners.
Yes, I'm an auditory learner.
Who is
that? I'm an auditory learner. Sir, Ryan Devane.
Ryan Devane. Okay. How do you study? Can you share your study habits?
So mostly me and my grandmother. So my grandmother makes me study. So we read. She reads and she explains the chapter to me. And I gauge it in the first try only. And then when she asks me questions, I answer them.
Okay, very good. That's a perfect example of an auditory learner. Now, the kinesthetic learners. So somebody asked me, what does a kinesthetic learner means? I'll explain to you later. But right now, anybody who can't sit in one place and study, take a book and walk up. Take a book and walk up and down. Take a pencil and make a notes.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir. Then, Yaman.
Okay. So these are kinesthetic learners are all about. Okay, let me see. And I'll come to that when I'm explaining. Now let's see visual learners, as that boy mentioned it. Visual learners have got a very strong sense of color. Okay, so that's a sense of color. They want to see in order to know it. Only when they see, they understand better. They have a very difficulty with the spoken directions. If somebody tells you in the classroom, do this, do that, you know, it will go above your head. As a visual learner, if somebody says, write it down, you write it down, you highlight it, that will remain with you. Okay. And has troubles following lectures, like just auditory lectures. Okay. Now, how can you study if you're a visual learner? As already the boy already has said it, a visual learner, you can create a color coding system for different colors can be used for different parts. Okay. So when you have to learn a definition, you can underline with something or color is with something. When you have to by heart a term, you can color with something. So therefore, these colors will remain in your memory, and then you'll get back to that. So color coding is important. Color coding can be used for organizing your assignment, your exercises, your worksheets, and also the various work that you have completed. So that's the visual learners can do. Yeah. And also directions, you can write all the direction that the teachers give you, or you know, wherever the board gives you, you write it down. And if you have already written down, highlight it. So therefore it impacts you, okay? You understand better, okay? And also you can use your diagrams, flow charts in order to understand better. These are the visual learners can do it. You know, there's a mind map. You can also create a mind map, visual learners, okay? How many of you know what's a mind map? Anybody knows what's a mind map?
Yes, sir, I know what's a mind map.
Okay, so if you know the mind map, the entire chapter can be drawn as a diagram. Am I right? And at the gist, you can learn that by looking at that one page, you can learn everything as a revision. Yes. Okay, so let's see the auditory learners. So what do the auditory learners do? Actually, they like to receive information by listening. They're like that boy said, the grandmother reads and he understands. Okay, that is what it is. Okay. But he has difficulty with the following written instructions. Okay. So because he doesn't like to read, only listen. Okay. Now has difficulty with reading and writing. Some of you may find it, I can't read. I don't want to read. You know, it's already said, I don't want to read. Okay. I can't read. So these are the auditory learners. So how do you study? As that boy said, somebody can read for you. Okay. That becomes easy. Someone can ask questions, okay, and then you can give the answers. It's like taking the answers, like, you know, when you are in the small lower classes, the parents did that, the mommy did that, you know, and made you to read, and then she used to ask the questions, used to answer. Also, the other way, you can record somebody's voice, you know. So if you want to record your own voice or your mommy's voice or a teacher's voice, you can record and play it time and again, whichever the concepts that you find is difficult to remember. So this is what is the auditory learners can learn at a simple way. Now, what about the kinesthetic learners? They would like to touch with their hands, okay? That is what, when they feel it, okay? Then only they will remember. So most of you, when you're doing something, activities in the classroom, when you do activity or some practicals, so you enjoy, you know, when there are exhibitions in schools, you enjoy doing that. And I can say 60 to 70% of the students in the school are kinesthetic learners, because nobody wants to sit in one place and study. You all would like to move around. You know, you want to prefer your hands, you play with your pencils, you play with your hands, scribble on your paper when you're studying. But that's the way of your studying. But you know, when your mommy daddy sees that, they may not like it. Okay, their learning style may be different and your learning style is different. Yeah. So you find difficulty sitting still. So that's why I said. So therefore, what do you do?
you know, when you're studying, always prepare your study time in such a way that you must give frequent breaks in between. Okay. So don't sit for a long period of time for 50 minutes or 60 minutes, but give a break. Or if you feel, take a book and walk up and down and read. Or you can also you can underline, you can learn the spelling, write the spelling. Okay, these are the things that you can do, the kinesthetic learners. Yeah, okay, the next,
When I'm studying, I underline each word in the textbook, and then each and every important word, I underline it twice or thrice.
Okay.
So like, it takes away my,
takes away your time, but the next time when you're reading, it reduces your time of studying. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. First time it takes away your time, but next time it does not take away your time. Next time you're, saving that much of time. Okay. Can we have the next slide?
So I have a doubt. I have a difficulty in finding the type of my learning, the style of my learning. Because while the teacher is explaining me something, like giving me examples or something, I'm able to understand it. The voice of the teacher. While I'm studying, I walk and study, and I cannot actually even bear if anyone's playing music around me. So that it's like actually the type of kinesthetic learners, the ability of the kinesthetic learners, and that is, so I'm finding it difficult to find the type of learner I am.
See, as I told you, you're Devna.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I told you earlier, you see, none of us have only one particular learning style. All of us have got all three different learning styles. Of course, there are more learning styles, okay? Now, when you say you don't have to really identify which learning style right at this moment, if you have this all in, did you do the exercise what was sent?
Yes, I did.
So where did you fall in the major predominantly?
So mostly in the auditory and kinesthetic.
Okay, they are equal.
Yes.
So what you could do is that when you see, this is also in the classroom and somebody is teaching you and these type of things, you can make a note of it. You can write a few points about it. Am I right? When the teacher is teaching, there are main points. Or if you have a textbook is open, you underline it. Okay. And when you are studying on your own, you go through that. Or, just somebody mentioned earlier, make your own notes. Underline these questions or points, make your questions. This is the different ways, all three styles can be utilized for your study purpose. So if you can't identify which is a learning style, that's fine. There is nothing to worry about it. But however, whatever the methods that you are studying, if it benefits you, absolutely fine. Yeah, you can combine all the three ones together. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, welcome. Okay, so let's go to the next one. So now, you have something in order to study smart and not hard, you need to have some very clear goals in mind, okay? Goals will of course provide direction for your study. Their prime objective is to keep you focused on the right things and motivated to take massive action. As I said, when you have a goal, right in the beginning I said, if you have a goal of attaining 95%, so that's a set goal, am I right? Then you put the process in place, okay? Come downwards in order to achieve 95. Okay, what should I do? Okay, all this process that you need to put down. Okay, so coming down. So I have given you this one acronym on there, SMART. Anybody knows what this SMART stands for? Your goals should be SMART. We say you should look smart. Okay, the Marians look smart. Am I right? This is what you all say. Okay, every school's children will say we look smart, but Marians a little more. We look smart. We are smarter than anyone else. Okay. Tell me, anybody knows what exactly this SMART stand for? Then you will be able to set goals. Yeah? Viraj?
So I don't know.
Don't know. Come on, you can try. There's nothing, as I said, there's nothing wrong or right answers. These are open-ended questions. Anyone else? Out of 127 people, somebody should be able. Nobody. Okay, let me say. See, you have the SMART. There are SMART. So your goal has to be SMART. That is, it has to be specific. Okay. Okay. The next one, it should be measurable. Then the third A is that attainable. Then the next is a realistic and the time bound.
So this is what it is. Let's see the next slide, whether there is explanation is there. Ah, yes. So it is a specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and time bound. Okay. Anybody can give me an example now? What would be, as a student, your specific goal, measurable goal, attainable goal, realistic? Now, if somebody says, as I've been saying it time and again, oh, I want to get 98%. Is it specific?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
it's specific. Is it measurable?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Is it attainable?
Yes. So that depends on the person.
Yes, exactly. It depends upon person to person. Is it realistic?
Yeah. So that also depends on the person.
Depends upon the person to person. And is it time bound?
Yeah.
Yes. In order to achieve this 98, there is a time bound. Am I right? The process is time bound. You can't study after the ICSE examination to get 98. Am I right? So there is. So as you mentioned, it is a specific. So therefore, you all please keep in your mind, measurable. At this moment, okay, as a student, you can say that, okay, we have a specific goal, we have a measurable goal, we have an attainable goal. But also, as somebody mentioned, it differs from person to person. Am I capable of getting that 98%? If I'm not capable of getting that 98%, okay, then you cannot give 98% is my goal, smart goal. No, because it is not attainable. It is not realistic for you, okay? So therefore, always keep in your mind, you always look at, you know, the things. At this moment, boys, you need to put a smart goal for yourself in the preliminary examination. So how would you put? So saying that, okay, in the first terminal examinations, I have got this, say, 70% marks. But next preliminary marks, I am going to get, say, I'm going to increase by 10%. So that's your specific goal. Okay, you're increasing. But when you say I'm increasing this 10%, you also need to put the process in place. How am I going to increase this? Okay, what is the process that will be involved? Okay, now once your preliminary is over, okay, now if you have said that I'm going to get 75%, you need to analyze your answer scripts. You know, how many of you have the habit of analyzing answer script? Now when I say analyzing, doesn't mean that you take your answer script when the teacher gives you. Of course, right now it's online papers. But even then, when there is a physical classes, when the paper is given to you, what does analyzing the paper means?
Not so just look at your mistakes and learn what you did wrong and improvise your answers and all that.
Very good, Pashwa. You know, most of the time what we do is that we look at our answer paper, we look at our friend's answer paper and then try to compare ourselves. So the very fact you are comparing yourself, you don't have a confidence in yourself, one, and you are creating a stress for yourself, okay? Because your friend might have got more than what you have got, and then you start thinking about it, he has got more. But what you need to, when you say analyzing your answer paper means, look at the answer paper thoroughly. See which are the concepts you have scored well, and which are the concepts that you need to improve. Make a list of those things. So once you make a list of this, once you analyze, then you see how did you manage to get those concepts, very clear ones, more marks, how did you manage to get it? That also you need to think about it. And okay, these are the concepts that I need to now work hard. How am I going to work hard in the next examination in order to get the higher percentage? So this is what is called as analyzing your answer scripts. Okay, concept by concept, you need to analyze. Then only you'll get an idea where you are strong, your strong points, and where are your weak points. Okay, this is the important aspect for you when you are putting, okay, when you are specifying your smart goals. Yeah, somebody wanted to ask something?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So the attainable part, sir, so before you set any goal, so you will have to think that it is attainable. That becomes a positive attitude, right? You can't think that it's not attainable.
Absolutely, I agree with you. Okay, Mustansir, it is, when you say it is attainable, you also need to know that you have the capabilities to attain, am I right? So that is a positive attitude. But also when you say positive attitude, you also need to know your capabilities. Okay. So now tomorrow, today, if I have to go go onto the cricket field, or say I'm going to score 100 and I'm not a batsman. Okay. I'm a bowler. So I can perform better as a bowler, but not as a batsman. Am I right? So similar way, if you say I'm attainable, if you say 95, you need to ask yourself, have I ever got 95 anytime? Okay, one question.
Now, in order to, I'm just giving an example, doesn't mean that you are getting this, just an example, please don't take it as personally, okay? So if you're getting 65, 70, okay, in the day-to-day, or in the examinations in school, suddenly you say, I want to get 97, 98, so you need to ask a question, is it attainable? Is it realistic? If it is attainable, you say, yes, it's realistic for me, it is attainable for me, then you need to put the process in place, okay? So that is very important. So moment you put the process in place, start evaluating the process. You also need to make sure that when you put the SMART goals, you also need to have a system whereby you have to have a check and balances, am I right? So today you are doing something, next day something, then you need to see, okay, have I done what I have planned to do? So therefore there has to be some check and balances. Okay, so therefore keep that in your mind. Yeah,
sure.
Is it clear? Okay,
yes.
So let's see, effectively translates into the following four steps. One, specify exactly what you want to achieve. That's what I said. Describe the specific actions you will take. Set a realistic time frame for accomplishing these actions and outline how you will measure your progress. This is what I said it. I just repeated again, okay? Okay, now is it clear? Any questions on these, boys? Anything else before I go on to the some of the myths?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please, sir? If you have any questions, yes.
So when you said that during exams, then when we are checking our papers and everything and we are comparing it to our friends, we might get stressed and everything, but
yes,
so if we look at it on the positive side, so doesn't it help us motivate ourselves that he has got this much, I have to get more than him, and then we motivate ourselves to do more.
Okay, see, listen, anything that you want to achieve, don't make your friend or your partner as your what you call person to go to. Okay, he should not be your person to compete with whom are you competing?
Yourself.
Aye, absolutely. You're competing with yourself. Am I right? You're not competing with your partner. So,
yes,
you know, you may say positive, yes, my friend has got that much, but tomorrow you are trying to beat your friend, not better yourself. Yeah.
Right.
So when you try to beat your friend, then the entire focus gets shifted. Okay, but when you say, I have to beat my earlier performance, then the focus shifts. Then you start putting in more effort for yourself because it is for your own good. It's for your own growth. It is not for competing with your friends. Never to compete with your friends, please. Because you may say, if you look at positively my friend's marks, it may motivate me. No, most of the time, 99% it demotivates you. One. Second, 99% your parents will come and say, okay, saying that you know, see, your friend is getting so many marks, why you are not getting the marks? Am I right?
Right.
So therefore, you know, keep the friend's marks aside, see for yourself, you know, as I said, evaluate yourself and you know, compete against your own self, not against your friends. Okay, any other questions?
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Any other questions?
Excuse me, sir. So, but sometimes what happens is that you have got an answer wrong and you don't know exactly why you have got the answer wrong. So then, is it right to correlate with your friend's paper and then like learn from it basically? That what has my friend written so that he has got it right?
Yes, absolutely. That is fine. But you're not looking at the marks. You're looking at the question that you have got it wrong. So in order to correct it, so you're looking into something. Am I right? Looking into something. Yes, so in order to learn. But you also have a teacher to help you, am I right?
Yes.
Rather than your friend. You also have a teacher. You also have your notebooks or a textbook to help yourself. That would be the best way. But however, sitting down, talking and sitting down, discussing answer with your friend is the best way of teaching or studying. That also is there, okay? So instead of looking at the paper, you can always ask your friend, okay, come on, so-and-so, I have got wrong this, what is the answer? Can you just read out to me? You know, that would be the best, you know, if he has got full marks. So otherwise, the best way to discuss with the teacher or go through your textbooks or notebook to get more of that. Yeah? Okay. Anything else? Anybody else? Otherwise, can I go on to the next point?
So I have a question.
Yes, sir.
So how do we draw a line between being optimistic and being realistic?
Being optimistic and realistic. It's a very fine line. Am I right?
Yeah.
That's what I said first in the beginning. I said you have to believe in yourself. Believe in your capabilities. Okay. So you need to first introspect and see what are your capabilities. Okay. You know, it is also good to be an optimist. Okay. As also need to be realistic.
Okay, so when you introspect and see what are your inbuilt strength, inner strengths are, so automatically you'll become realistic rather than optimist. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So can we go to the next? If anybody else, any other questions? Okay. So let's go to the next. You know, most of the times we have those myths. Am I right? Now I would hear from you boys. Somebody said right in the beginning, you know, I say I can study better with music on. Am I right? How many of you say that?
Yes.
Yes. So yes, the music, sir. The rock music on, am I right? Rock and pop music on, dancing music on, the your headphones are on and with the book in your hand.
So more of soft music, not rock.
Soft music. Okay.
Lo-fi, hip-hop.
Do you think it is advisable to have music on when you're studying?
So only for subjects like mathematics, yes, for sir. Flow.
Yes, sir.
For subjects like mathematics, where you can get a flow with the music.
Okay, you get a better flow with the music. Okay.
Part is a theory with
only music. Only when you have to mark practicals. Take it in that.
You know
so
what?
It depends on person to person. So yes. Some people might get distracted. Some might actually like it.
Okay. So it is. If you're really into music, I can say, you know, listen, you can compose a tune to these mathematical problems, you know, and then sing that to yourself. And, you know, that's the music. So the musical, you know, intelligence also gets activated. So it becomes easy for you to learn mathematics. But however, let me tell you, I'm not saying you are wrong. You know, some of you can study better with the music on. What I'm trying to say is that, is the music systems are in place at, what do you call, in the examination hall? What type of environment is created in the examination hall?
So it's very serious.
Silent zone.
Silent zone. Quiet, specific quiet zones. Am I right? You are to yourself. Okay. You can't even look here, there, speak to anyone else. Okay. But then when you're preparing yourself for the examinations, what are you training your mind for with the music on? Mind is getting used to the music. Am I right? Mind is getting used to your studying. So the mind is doing two things. So when you go into the examination hall, what is the mind trying to search for?
Music.
Music. And when there is no music, what happens? This is what I'm trying to communicate. I'm not
saying you'll get restless.
You'll become restless one. You know, you may turn, just go blank. May go blank. I'm not saying that you will go blank. But these are the myths. That's what I'm saying, you know. You know, having a music on, whatever the type of music may be, you're studying. Because you can have concentrate on one thing. Now I'll give an example. Can you put, if you want to cross a stream and go on to the other side and you have two boats, so will you place your two legs in two different boats and go on to the other side?
No,
you'll jump into one boat. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Why are you jumping into one boat?
Because
why are you jumping into one board?
Completely correct, or then you don't do it.
So yeah, it will focus. It will take you directly to the place where you want to go. Am I right? But if you have got two legs in two different boards, what you will do? Will you be able to manage?
So it either becomes very difficult, or the boat might topple over and you might fall.
Yes, exactly. It is just like that. When you're having two different things you are doing, the mind is traveling in two boards. Okay. One is a study, one is a music. So I do not know how well you will grasp what you are studying. Okay, of course you may grasp music, but I don't know how well you grasp your studies. But what I can suggest to you, if you're really musically inclined, what I just now told you, you can compose a tune to those difficult subjects and difficult concepts and listen to that. That would be the best thing. Because that, as I mentioned earlier, your musical intelligence gets activated and you learn faster. You know, like as junior school children, we learn the tables faster when they are put to tune, you know, tables. You know, somebody sings the tables and they immediately pick it up. So therefore, that is what music is always easier to learn.
Even the alphabet, so like the ABC song.
Exactly, exactly. That's why in the lower classes, you learn faster. Am I right? The same way, if you want a musical, you are musically inclined, give a tune to that and learn. But however, I strongly advise you, keep the music aside. Create an environment for yourself, for your body and for your mind, the same environment in which you have to sit and give your paper. Okay, so therefore, don't have to hunt for the music on. Okay, because to be frank, the examinations are not held in during the Ganpati festival where you can hear all this music loud. Am I right? Okay, the next one is, what is the next one says? I can remember better if I just listen. Yes, auditory learners can do that, but all of us can't be. Am I right? You need to make sure that when somebody is talking to you, somebody is, you know, dictating to you, somebody is saying something, you better write down points, underline the points, you know, all this. Anything that you study, boys, please keep in your mind, when you make a note of it, when you write it down, it registers faster. You know, it remains for a long period of time. And the next one is that, besides that, when you study something, two or three of you together, you can discuss the same topic. You know, it's like that, okay, boy A studies this concept, boy B studies this concept, boy C studies this concept. Three of you can come together and discuss, you know, you're saving time. And when you're discussing this, what happens is that you learn faster, you learn from one another. You know, retention power takes place when you teach someone else. That is why we teachers, when we teach, we have been teaching for many years. So therefore, we have been teaching the students. Am I right? Now, when we come into the classroom, we can just teach without textbook, without anything. We just keep on teaching. Am I right? So that is because we have been teaching for many years. So the same way, if you can teach one another, you retain those things for a long period of time and remember. So this is the best way of going ahead, you know. The next point says, I work better under pressure. Can anybody tell me how many of you work under pressure? How many of you work under pressure?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, not all the time, am I right? So when you're not prepared, when you're not planned your study, as I said, when you're not set your goal right in the beginning and you're not planned well, okay, automatically you are going to come under pressure. There are some boys, students, you know, oh, I can study last minute. You know, and when what happens, there are only two things can happen. One is you just give up and that leads to stress. Am I right? Because you can't complete. You say, it's not possible for me to do it. I'm not going to study. I'm going to study only these three chapters. I'm not going to study another four chapters. So the stress builds up. So you don't know what questions are going to come up. So the best thing is that to plan right from the beginning. Prepare your plan, prepare your study. You have to prepare your timetable. Okay. Or the last minute you try to give your best. Okay. Then you say, well, I have studied whatever I could and I will go for examination and give my best. That's all. Okay. These are only two things can happen, but always keep in your mind, it is not under pressure. It is very difficult because the mind cannot study. Okay. Mind cannot work under pressure. Okay, so there is a certain period, certain level only it can take in. Okay, now let's see the next one. What are the various factors that affects your study? Anybody knows what are the factors that affects your study?
Excuse me, sir.
What so various yes. study.
I had a question.
So environment.
Yes. Who had the question? Yes.
Sir, regarding the third point.
Yes.
Third often happens to me so that the same chapter with before the exam, I do it in like 1 hour. I did two hours to do the same thing 1 month before the exam. So
yeah,
like that
Mostan say, if you are studying before the 2 months before the examination, you are studying for the first time trying to understand, am I right? The same chapter you are studying just before the examination because most of the things you know now, you are just glancing through, you are going through. So when you are looking at the chapter, we are looking at the things because all the things that you have studied earlier, because if you have studied properly, it will come back to your memory. You know, it's like that, getting into the memory, you know, computer, clicking onto that, you know, type something, the computer will give you the list of things that is there. Am I right? So it's similar way. So therefore, but if you're studying for the first time, just 1 day before, I doubt, Mustan said, that you will not be under pressure. You will study fast. It's difficult. So you have to at least study once before. You need to make sure that you have a certain idea about that chapter, that concept. Then you can say, okay, 1 day before the examination, I'm just glancing through, I'm going through, I'll learn better. Am I right? So that I can say that. Okay, the next, anybody else? Okay, so let's go to the next. Okay, what are the various factors that affect? Okay.
So where you sit, so how you study, so when do you start studying?
When do you start studying?
So means also at the start of the year or like in the last 3-4 months? So
okay, your study should be a complete ongoing process, boy. Pashwa, it's not just the last.
I always start like just after the summer vacations only.
Yeah.
So, but many students do like in the last 3-4 months only.
So, okay, let me tell you that the people who start right from the beginning on a
you know, step-by-step study, they always will have a peaceful mind and a restful days before the examination, and which is very important before you go for examination, to have a complete peaceful mind, stress-free mind. Now, the people who start just a month before, they will always will have a little stressful mind. Yeah, always before the examinations, I always believe that you must, you know, if you're good at singing or anything, you sing for yourself, relax yourself. One day before the examination should be the least amount of study, boys. Very least amount of study. You must relax. Mind has to be at rest. So that is what it is. So therefore, right from the beginning, you need to study step by step. That's why I said you need to have a goal in mind right from the beginning. You can't set a goal just 1 month before. It's not possible. Now, for example, the cricketers or footballers, you know, all of you, many of you must be playing football and cricket for your school. Am I right? Of course, this year, unfortunately, you could not play, but at least for the earlier years. Were you just selected on morning of the game and then say, okay, come on, you are in the team, come, let's play the football match? Was it? Was it? Or you had a practice training right through the year?
Throughout the year practice.
Throughout the year practice, same thing. And then you can go and perform, am I right? And even then, when you go onto the field, you are still more stressed. Okay, how are we going to perform? Where are we going to win? Anything. So still you have that little bit of stress. But if you're just going on one night before you're selected, go to the field, so you will find difficult. You see the cricketers also say, no? One day before or the morning, somebody falls sick, they pick up. They're not in the frame of mind to go and play. Okay? So you need to have a very strong mindset or a mental balance. Okay. The next, let's see about what are the factors. One is a diet. Am I right? Yeah. During examination time, you need to be very careful about what you eat. You need to take care of your health, boys. That's very, very important. Of course, this year you have to be very, very careful about your health. You must take care of yourself. You have to stay safe. Okay? Diet also is a very important aspect. You can't be eating any junk food during the examinations. Okay? And you cannot be having very late night dinners. Of course, these days, I don't know how many of you go outside for partying. I'm not. But a lot of water you need to drink. I think you can, communicate to me. Now, when you're studying seriously, you feel hungry more. Am I right? More than when you go and play. So when you're studying, you feel hungry, you feel thirsty. So therefore, you need to keep a bottle of water next to you. I would prefer that you keep a glass of, you know, bottle of, you know, dry fruits. Keep munching those dry fruits, you know, that gives you energy. That's very important to have a physical as well as mental energy. So you can't be sitting down without proper water, getting dehydrated, okay? The next point I said, sleep. 7 to 8 hours sleep is a must. Okay, more than that, if you sleep is good, but not necessary that you need to sleep for 10, 15 hours and study only for, you know, a few hours. So 7 to 8 hours sleep is a must. And also, you should be a stress-free. Mind has to be stress-free. When I say listen to the inspirational music, doesn't mean that you listen to the music while studying. But during the breaks, you know, you need to plan your study. So during the break, you can listen to this inspirational music. Yoga is another one. Best way of relaxing. Am I right? How many of you do yoga? It's very good if you can do yoga. You know, it's very good for relaxation. You know, you take break. That makes break. Yeah.
Sometimes.
Okay. It's very necessary. You know, this deep breathing is important even nowadays. Am I right? For this pandemic, they say, you know, if your lungs are very strong, you at least you build up your immunity for this. So therefore, every morning, get up and do those breathing exercise, you know, deep breathing exercise. I'm sure your mommy, daddy must be doing. So you also better do that deep breathing exercise. You know, you will clear up all your negative thoughts when you do this deep breathing. Okay. Okay. Now let's go on to the next. You need to avoid your stress. Go to the next slide. Avoid a stress. As I say, you also need to be in a positive state of mind every time. As I told you earlier, I repeat again, use the magic mantra, I can, I will, and I must. This should be your, you know, statement all the time now till the examination. Picture yourself being successful. Always say, oh, I'm going to be successful. Okay. Avoid talking with peers who feel they are underprepared. Now, this is another important aspect, students. You know, as I said, you are competing against yourself, not against your friend. Also, your learning style is different than your friend's learning style. Sometimes your friends will call because there are plenty in the world to spread the negativity. So your friend may say, oh, yeah, I've not studied. I'm so bad at this chapter, you know, and then suddenly he may say that, oh, yeah, this chapter is very important. Earlier, you had discussed saying that, okay, we'll leave this chapter out.
suddenly just before the examination, he may call up and say, oh, we need to leave this chapter out, you know, study the chapter, you know, important chapter this season, then suddenly you get stressed out. So therefore, don't give in to these peers. You make your own study habits. You make your study plan. You see what you need to study and go stand by that. Okay. And you need to stand by that. What are your plans? You stand by that. Please don't go to others. Yeah. Do not try to follow your friend's style of study. As I told you, some of you are an auditory learner, some of you are kinesthetic learners, some of you are visual learners, some of you are early morning learners, some are late morning or late night learners. So therefore, you see what it is. Make a plan for yourself from today and then see. And try to remain calm and focused on the task that is coming up. Okay. You always need to be focused on what your goals that you have set. Okay, the next slide would say how to make a study plan. Okay, next, yeah. Please make a study plan, okay? Look at everything you need to cover for the exam. So you know, no, every chapter you need to study. How many chapters you can study? Make that study thoroughly right in the beginning when you start your plan, okay? Look at the dates of examinations. Of course, this year, unfortunately, ICS exam dates are not out, but at least I'm sure your preliminary dates are out. So see how much time you will have before this preliminary examination to prepare. So you divide your study sessions accordingly, keeping in mind which chapters you are, which subjects you are given more time, which chapters are you already prepared so you can give less time, okay? So once you have plan, you stick to this plan, okay? Yeah, so now, as I said, going to the, preparing your timetable. How do you prepare your timetable? Go to the next slide now. Okay, we already said your plan. You plan your, then decide from what time you're going to study. I told you already that. Break up your time frame into blocks or modules. That is morning, afternoon, evening. This is what we discussed earlier. So you need to stick to this point. Okay, we'll go to the next. And when you're making a plan, see, this is where somebody mentioned earlier, mix up your memory and a skill, difficult and easy subjects. You cannot say, okay, today I'm going to study mathematics for 4 hours. Your mind is not going to take that in. Today I'm going to study history and complete the history portion. That is not going to happen. Okay, it is like that, you know. If your mommy prepares the same dish every day, okay, will you like it? Or a mommy says, okay, morning breakfast, lunch and dinner, you're going to have this, only this. So will you like it? No, you won't like it. Okay. And that also in economics, we say it is what you call as a diminishing marginal utility. As you consume one thing, the next time what you consume, it has got a lesser value. So similar way, if you're going to study one subject, which is a difficult subject or an easy subject for that matter, throughout the day or for 3 hours, your mind, readiness of your mind keeps decreasing. So, you know, that is what you need to keep in your mind. So therefore you mix up this memory and the skill, like sometimes history, then you've got a history, then you've got a biology. These are all memorizing mostly, am I right? Then your skill like a mathematics, a physics, then you've got a certain geography, like that. Difficult and easy subjects, you need to decide which is your difficult subject, which is your easy subject. So make the plan accordingly. See, take the memory subjects when you're fresh. Normally in the mornings, you need to, if you are fresh or late in the evening, when you are fresh, whatever it is, you take that subject like a history, which you have to mug up, memorize certain things, you take those up. And the skill or writing subjects when you are tired, okay, if you have to study a language or if you have to do some mathematics, you know, not very tired, but at least a time that when you can say you are not very fresh. Then fit in time for breaks. You take 1 hour every time study, make it into 50 plus 10. Now, when I say 50 plus 10, what does it mean? It's not a 50 minutes break and 10 minutes study. It should be the other way around. It should be 50 minutes study and the 10 minutes break. Now, what do you do during this break? You need to give a complete break for your mind. Okay. Not sitting and watching the videos or not sitting and watching the TV channels. Okay. Maybe you can listen to the soft music or just close your eyes and just 10 minutes, you take a nap, relax, just go around walking, rejuvenates your body as well as your mind. So please do that. So therefore break this up. Then go over your timetable every day after dinner to see whether you are completed, because you need to divide the entire study time depending upon what you're going to study. And at the end of the day, before you go to sleep, okay, you need to revisit those timetable and see whether you have been successful.
Now, if you are not completed what you are set out to complete, what will happen? You are carrying forward to the next day. So the next day will become a burden. Okay, additional thing comes in, you know, carry forward. And then keep the last hour for revision of all your memory subjects you have studied that day. Okay, so that is the way you can plan. In short, I'm telling you. Okay, so now this is what I wanted to communicate to you boys. But however, if you have any questions right now, anything, but before I end, I will ask your webmaster to play that one video of when the song, which is a very famous song, all of you know. And I also mentioned about Michael Jordan, who was a famous basketball player. You know, maybe after this song is over, then you can, we can ask questions. You know, the song is that, I Believe I Can Fly. How many of you heard this? How many of you know this song?
For me, sir.
Yeah, yes, all sir. Of you, am I right? It's a famous song, I Believe I Can Fly. And that is very apt for today's what we are talking about. You know, you need to believe in yourself, believe in your capabilities, okay? Believe in your strengths more than your weaknesses. Compete against your own self. I'm just summarizing now. Compete against your own self, not your friends. Set a SMART goals. Remember that, SMART, okay, acronym. So set a SMART goals and set a process in place in order to achieve those goals. Okay, with this, let's watch this video, okay, the song, and then after that, we take some questions. Okay, with this, I really thank Father Swami for giving me an opportunity to address these Marian boys. I think after 17 years, you know, I was feeling so nostalgic, I can say, talking to the Marians. Okay, and I'm so happy that some of you really interacted. I hope you'll carry some message with you. I hope it is something that you can put into practice. Simple, okay? I'm sure you have been hearing this time and again, but this is just to reinforce us. Hi, Miss Clementine, how are you?
Good morning, sir. Sorry, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Clementine, nice will to... ask, we'll give a chance to the students
yes.
to ask some questions. They could put the questions in the chat box. So we also, will read out the questions.
Also, Father, you can ask the boys to send in their feedback, so it will be nice for me, constructive feedbacks.
Surely.
Yeah?
Surely. Yeah. Any questions, students, kindly put in the chat box. I can read it from here.
Yes. Some of them ask during the session only. No, I don't know whether they're asking anybody.
Uh-huh.
Only those few boys. It's always, no, in the classroom, only few boys ask questions.
No questions?
They may be frightened that you are
Viraj.
There.
Viraj, you want to ask?
Yeah, okay, Viraj, ask. Go ahead, Viraj.
So this is the first time you start. I started studying from the starting of the year. Right now, I'm mentally very tired because of studying, and I can't get my mind to study, but exams are coming near.
Yeah, but you know, Viraj. Okay, whatever, it is okay, I'm sorry. Okay, you know, when you are studying that, you know, also need to know that you need to have a certain sufficient breaks. You can't be studying throughout. You know, when you are studying right from the beginning, so you also need to make sure that you study at a pace, not everything together. And also, if you have any passion, okay, if you have any talent, you need to also develop that in between. So therefore, your mind gets deviated. I always used to say, even at Mary's, I used to tell the boys, you know, before the examinations, if you have a football match, go and play. I used to push them. I still remember in the month of February in the year when I was training the St. Mary's boys for cricket, I don't know whether Clemmy remembers, I used to train them for a cricket coaching. So in the month of February, there was semi-finals, and I had to call all these boys and I had to speak and, you know, brainwash the parents to send the students to go and play the cricket match semi-final in the Jail Shield. And tell you, of course, they lost to that one of Sradashram, Sachin Tendulkar's team, but they came and played. I'll tell you, all 18 boys got 90 plus that year. You know, all those boys and all this, you know. So when you are studying, you also need to make sure that you practice your passion, Viraj. Okay, because only study also gets you cramped, your mind gets cramped. So therefore, you know, the break and then have some passion followed. Are you good at music? Are you good at sports or something?
Yes, I like to solve Rubik's Cube.
So you practice that in between just to deviate from the study, you know. So this is what happens. I don't know whether Miss Clementine knows this example. We had two boys, brothers, both were brilliant in 90s only. I don't want to mention the name. Brilliant. One fellow was, you know, the prelims. And everybody thought he would come first to the ICSE examination. It's just like this, you know, he was completely burnt out. Though I used to tell the mother, please don't push him, send him for debate, send him for this. The mother did not send him, you know, pushed him. And unfortunately, the boy got 90, though the highest that year at the St. Mary's was 94%. And the second boy was in the 9th standard. And I told the mother, please don't make the same mistake that you made with the older fellow. And the second boy who took part in all these activities, literary activities and basketball, and he topped the school. I don't remember, you know, those Mehtas, you know, those two brothers, Mehtas. You remember, no?
Arnav and Aro,
yes. So, you know, this is what it is. You know, you need to enjoy your life, enjoy what you want to do best. Yeah, Viraj, I hope I
made
you understand a little bit. For the time being, even if the examinations come, no? For the time being, just keep your books aside and enjoy the life, you know? Tell your mommy, I don't want to see the books now for some time.
Paul, there are a couple of other questions on the chat box.
Yes.
Is it important to make a list of things you will do every day?
It is very, very important. When you are planning, you need to put down. And I'm sure Father Swami also, early morning, he puts down, or the previous day, puts down what is the next day I have to do. So always you need to jot down your next day's program. And as and when you finish, like a student's studying, as and when you finish that, you cut it off, take it off. So then you know exactly at the end of the day, how much is left over and how much you are completed. You yourself feel happy. It is very important to make a list of things, not only as a student, as also other way.
Yeah. The next question, sir, how many hours we need to study in a day?
Okay, that's a nice question. So how many hours do you want to sleep? That's the first question, okay? Minus that hours. So then 7 hours if you are sleeping and now you are at home. You know, it all depends upon your capability, boy, whoever it is. It also depends upon your capabilities. But as you are coming closer to the examinations, sometimes 1 month before the examination, you can increase. But as you're coming very close to the examinations, you must decrease the time. I can't say exactly how many hours. That depends upon individual capabilities. Yeah. But you can't be studying just for 1 hour or 2 hours. But that hours should keep on increasing to minimum 7 to 8 hours, you know, as you come closer.
Next question. There is a lot of studies. If we are continually studying, what is the best way to deal with pressure? Is it good to go out to play for half an hour in the evening?
It is very necessary. But, you know, if you are coming closer to the examinations, I would strongly advise you don't go and play any physical games. We never know what would happen. You may freak accidents and you may fracture your foot or a hand, then you'll have a problem. So what I would suggest is that, you know, that take a break. Your mommy, daddies, if they are sitting close to you, you know what? You need to go out for a walk with your parents. And these parents should always make sure that they don't discuss anything about the study that time. They only discuss about yourself, outside, other aspects of your life, but not the study completely out. That 1 hour walk would be a very refreshing walk. We have many examples. I can say that, you know, even at campaign, I had one boy, you know, he followed to the core, taking with his mother for a walk. And, you know, I was really surprised. And all of us were surprised at Mary campaign that he came first at the ICSC examination. And at the, on the papers and the results came in, mother and he came and said, thank you, sir. We followed what you said, that we went for a walk every day in the evening. Marine Drive. So, you know, completely detach yourself from the exam in the studies when you're walking with your parents. But I would strongly advise you go with your mommy daddy for a walk. That's a nice 1 hour quality time that a parents can spend with you.
Next question. Sir, with a lack of surety of when the board exams will be held, I have finished the portion a few times and I am now bored of the same portion. So how do I get myself to study the same thing again?
Okay, now if you feel that you're already ready. Now see, let us think about this. This pandemic virus has taught us many things in life. To be ready for everything, any eventualities, okay? Nothing is, future is uncertain. We don't know what when. So if you feel that you're already prepared, take a break for some time, relax. Don't go over and over again and again, okay? So it's like, you know, playing olden days, we used to play those musical LPs, you know, over and over and over and again, it is to get worn out, you know. So therefore, you don't relax yourself for some time, okay? Give some fresh, you know, what you call to your mind, freshness to your mind and body. And then when the examination comes, you can start. When the timetable comes, you can start if you feel that you have already ready for the examination, okay?
What should we do if we are not in the mood for studying?
That's a question I need to ask you, boys. When are you in a mood to study? That's a question, no? So that is, you need to ask when you are. What do you mean by when I'm not in a mood to study? Don't study. You have to have that positive outlook. Am I right? You need to have that mood to study. If you're not in a mood to study, but you can't say for 24 hours, I'm not in a mood to study. You know, therefore you need to divide. What is the time in the day that you will have a mood to study? That is all within you. It is you who have to talk to yourself. It is you yourself have to say, okay, this is the time I'm going to sit and study. Father Swami or Miss Clemmy or me, I cannot tell you this is the mood time for you. This is not the mood time for you. No, it is you who have to decide for yourself. Yeah?
Sir, how should we keep ourselves motivated to study and prevent ourselves from burning out?
That's what I told you earlier, you know, whatever you now make a list of things that you are very good at it. You are already prepared. make a list of the things that you need to put into, or I can say need to spend some time in order to master it. So don't worry about the things that you know already, and just put some time into the things that you need to concentrate on it. That's all. Because, you know, since you are not sure about examination, but at least now you are sure about your preliminary examination. But nowadays you also need to pay attention to the preliminary examination, boys. Okay, we never know what will happen. Like last year, prelim marks were taken into consideration. Am I right? Sometimes, some places. I don't know whether that's. So therefore, you need to be very careful. So therefore, give your best. Just like what you give your best for your board examination, give your best for your preliminary examination. Okay, so that is the marks which is counted everywhere. Even in international university, they'll ask for it. Yeah. So make a list of good and the areas for improvement.
So it often happens with me that I do grasp the information imparted by the teacher during the class. Therefore, I do not read the text, but my parents do insist on reading that subject. Sir, what should I do?
Yes, your parents are right. You know, whatever is heard in the class, okay, you have a good memory, you have good grasping power, you are blessed with that. But however, the assimilation of knowledge takes place when you go over again, you know, again and again, the same thing that you learned. The same day, if you go home, okay, and read what the teacher has taught in the class and make a small little notes for yourself, that will remain with you forever and you have done your work, you know. So therefore, you don't have to study. I think what your parents are saying is absolutely right. You need to also go through that, what the teacher has taught, and make a note of yourself. Assimilation of knowledge takes place when you go through that same content, what is taught in the classroom. So that's an important aspect. Yeah.
Sir, due to this pandemic, studies have moved to our next level, which is online studies. As a student, I find it really very boring to attempt online class, even though, in my mind, I know it is really important to study, but I just can't concentrate on online classes. What should I do?
Okay, I think I have no answer for that, Father, because online classes are, you know, everybody is getting stressed out. Teachers also don't feel enjoy, am I right? They also don't enjoy, neither we as educators enjoy. But as I told you right in the beginning, we need to know what exactly is good for us. You know, we need to make sure that this is important for us to do it. That's why I asked you first in the beginning, what is it important to study? You know, so therefore you need to answer that question. If this is the mode of studying, so therefore I need to study. There is no other option for me. Am I right? So you need to do that. So it is all in your hand, boy. It is all with you. You have to take a call on that.
How much do we study in a day if you are burdened by at least 4 tuitions every day?
Now, these are the questions that you need to answer, the students. You know, that's the biggest problem. You know, you will have classes going on in school, you'll have a tuitions going on. And unfortunately, students, my heart goes out to you all, because you have only 24 hours. In the 24 hours, you have to juggle between the classrooms, tuition classes and the school classes, tuition homework, school homework, tuition test, school test. And that side you have got a parents pressurizing you. This side you have got a school teacher. That side you have got your tuition teacher. I only can sympathize with you all, and you have only 24 hours. Now, the best thing is that too, self-study is the best medicine for all this. You know, self-study is the best medicine for all this. When you have a self-study, boy, you will have plenty of time for yourself. You know, when you have plenty of time for yourself, you will have a peace of mind. You'll be stress-free. Just see. Talk to those children who have, put into practice the self-study. So I think that is my message to you. Self-study is the best way of going forward at this time, at least, you know. Forget, once in a way, you can get your question answers corrected by the teachers, but don't be burdened yourself with all your, you know, from morning till evening tuition classes.
Even though I study better alone, My parents force me to study in front of them. What should I do? Tell them.
I think you need to build that trust in your parents, no? That you are studying. You know, they must be thinking that if you're studying alone, you're wasting your time. So you once in a way, you tell them, so you allow me to study on my own, and then you take up, see, I'll give you. You know, that must be your test, you know, trusting. You know, and then if you can give it, then you say, see, I studied and I gave you. Please allow me to study myself. Once in a way, you can come and take up. I'm there for you.
So, you know, you build that trust with your parents. That's very important. Trust factor is very important. Now, right now, maybe your family does not trust you that you are studying. They must have seen you wasting your time. So build that trust, yeah?
No. Okay. I think quite a number of questions have been answered.
Yes, Father.
And Sir Paul Machado has done an excellent job. We have with us Miss Clementine Montero, the vice principal of our school, was also the colleague of Paul Machado when Paul Machado was a vice principal in our school. Over to you, Clementine.
Thank you, sir. I've always been calling you sir, so it will be very difficult for me to call you Mr. Machado, but
I can always call anything.
So, dear Mr. Machado, you have so clearly spelled out all the areas which will help the students to keep their minds and body active, calm, and to create a stress-free atmosphere. Thank you for answering their questions, their queries so patiently, and, you know, really feeling for them, like, you know, like a parent feeling for the students, like, you know, it is true that one needs to study smart, not just hard. I'm sure that all our students do believe in themselves that they are going to do their very best. The mantra, I can, I will, and I must, will definitely take them a long way towards achieving success. Thank you, Mr. Machado, for the words of wisdom you have shared with our students. God bless you, sir. You will always remain Sir Paul for me. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, thank you. It's like a homecoming for me, actually, to Mary's. Unfortunately, online. I would have loved I would have loved to take this session in the auditorium or in the senior assembly hall. It brought all memories back.
I know, sir.
Yes. Thank you so much.
So he added a note to the previous question. Call you, not to worry.
What is that?
So the students also would have had a lot of nostalgia sitting in school.
Oh, yes. They are missing it.
Yes.
So he added a question. He added a note to his previous question. In the chat, he added after our
No problem.
Anything else, Paul? That's okay.
No, thank you so much. I would be very grateful, Clemmy and the father, if your boys can give me some constructive feedback, and you can email me that. Me that feedback. Yeah.
Surely, we'll collect that. Yeah.
Thank you.
So this session really helped us. So thank you.
Thank you.
So that one note is a question again.
All the best, my dear students. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye-bye. See you all.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye, sir.
Thank you, father. Thank you, Mr.
Welcome.
Thank you, Sir Ryan. Boys, kindly send your constructive feedback to father.
Okay. They are going hot on their own.